KSBW Weather with Jim Vanderzwan.
All right, needless to say, not everybody's sitting in front of the TV tonight. I got things to do, and a good night to do it, too. Clear skies, nearest precipitation is way up north into Montana and Idaho and out into the Plain States. Some of it's getting nasty. I'll show you that in a minute. Temperatures, though, still quite a spread here. Long thermometers for this late in the year. 64 yesterday in Watsonville, up to 71 after a low of 43, and it's still mild out there tonight. 60s, a couple of 70s in Santa Cruz County. These came in right about where we expected, and they're actually about 5 to 8 degrees above normal. So it's, we don't do this every Halloween, so enjoy it. 40s overnight, 60s to 70s around the Monterey Peninsula. Some of those temperatures feel better than summer's day at the high point of the day. Up to 77 in Soledad, got 76, Salinas and Greenfield, 74 in Gonzales and King City, and 72 for San Jose and Gilroy, a little bit warmer there in Hollister with a nice 75. Matched up pretty good, too, with the rest of the state. A little bit warmer down in Van Nuys, 82. That even bested Palm Springs, 81. 57 at Lake Tahoe. Then it gets a little bit colder as you move east. Not super cold yet. It's not winter. It's still fall. 50s in Boise and Denver, 73 Dallas, 64 in Chicago. But the temperatures don't tell the whole story. Look at this guy. Stretching from north of the Great Lakes all the way down into the Gulf of Mexico, the leading edge of an upper-level low-pressure system with some cold air here, producing lots of moisture. A lot of this is subtropical moisture from what was Tropical Storm Raymond, and this is causing some flooding. It started in Texas earlier today. It's now moving along the Mississippi River Valley. Severe thunderstorm watches were popping up last night. Then they went away. They came up again. The red boxes indicate potential for tornadoes down around the Gulf Coast and even the Ohio Valley. So a lot of places they've been putting Halloween on hold. They're going to do it tomorrow night because it's just too dangerous to be out between the rain and the wind and the possibility of tornadoes. It's a rugged night. The proverbial dark and stormy night, to be sure, and it could get dangerous. Tomorrow, it weakens a little bit. You don't get quite the intensity, except in the upper plains and a little bit down around Georgia. Nonetheless, there'll be a lot of wind here. These are the upper level pressure pattern here, and at the surface, they're going to be strong. You're looking at 40, 50 mile an hour winds. You can bet some planes aren't going to make it on schedule tomorrow. High pressure ridge here, and we have a system upstream that's coming along the coast there, just getting organized right here. But because of that mountain of high pressure that's over us, it's only going to flatten the ridge and not get too close to us. Might see a few showers along the California-Oregon border. Lines, we kind of had a little data problem here, but you can see right up around the northern part of the state there, Saturday night, Sunday, pulls out of town. The trough moves inland. The next system also focused way to the north. Perhaps Thursday and Friday we could get it in the North Bay counties. I don't know if we'll see it here. We'll keep you posted. Meanwhile, cooled in the morning, but not as cold as it was earlier in the week. Nice tomorrow. Another great day of above normal temperatures. Microcast picking up on that. A little more cool air and breeze coming in Saturday night and Sunday. We could get some windy conditions, particularly up in the Santa Cruz Mountains, overnight on Saturday into Sunday. So it's going to feel different. We're going to split the weekend down a little bit here. Looks like it'll be a little bit cooler on Sunday than I originally thought. Still a nice one tomorrow, though, day one of November and a Friday. Looking good. 70s all the way around after overnight lows in the 40s, so it doesn't get a whole lot better. You might as well enjoy these because the year wears down and those days get shorter. It is harder and harder to get all of this stuff going up into the 70s. 80s, few and far between already. We might find a couple down in the south end of the valley, but that's it. Clear tonight, and we're going to go with sunny tomorrow. Looking pretty good. Oh, trick or treat, of course. Well, we're pretty much the remnants of that for tomorrow. And November 2 is looking good. Sunshine as well. Overnight lows staying well above freezing. They'll chill out a little bit more around about Wednesday or Thursday. We'll get some upper 30s going. And for high temperatures, we stay mild. We cool off Sunday. Now, stay on this for a minute, Mike, because we also have one more thing to do this weekend, and that is, of course, Pacific Standard Time. Sunday, 2 a.m. Now, you don't have to stay up for it. You can do this Saturday night. If you got to be anywhere on Sunday, you better do a couple of the clocks anyway Saturday night. Set them back 1 hour. Spring ahead, fall back, and you get an extra hour of sleep.
Wow. Otherwise, you might be early.
Yeah, that's right. So there
be
you go.
Be early for a few things.
All right.